Hey folks, here's an example of my final finished a different iteration of a possible dashboard when you're working with a lot of data and wanting to analyze it. In this example, this is a set of heart data. We actually have the data hidden over here behind this group, and this is the data set that we're analyzing. It's the heart data of looks like 918 different patients, and we're hiding the data over there so we can peek at it if we want. We've got all this set up on a single tab, and then I have some helper stats here. What I'm doing with these is using the array literal and naming this top line all. And then I'm using a sort unique and looking at the data and pulling in all the data that is all the data that you see here in these numbers. And we're, those are organized in ascending numeric. And then we're doing the same thing with the gender and the all of these different criteria that you see labeled here: chest pain type, resting BP. So these are all those particular formulas that pull in all that data. And then here I'm transposing all of the data that we see here. I actually have row one hidden. Let me pull that up. So you can see this data here. I'm actually pulling in that data here. And then I have an array formula that's actually pulling for me the column header. So age is on AC, sex is on AD. We're doing that with this array formula, if, len, substitute, address. Kind of a big long formula here that's basically finding a match for me on the column where it finds the word age and then giving me that column header, which I need over here in my query. And my query is a long string of if statements that is pulling the data from this data set over here. So let me just show you how this works. So as you use your filters here, and let's say we want to start with age 35 and the upper age is 44. We can see we found 157. If we want to just look at our females, we're down to 36. We want to just look at a specific pain, chest pain type, and maybe let's change in one here. Exercise angina, no. Let's say yes. Oh, none of those bring anything back. Let's say old peak, or let's see, this one is down. Nope, we don't get anything there. Flat. Up. Okay, we get 13. But what you can see is as you use your controls, you'd have to come back and change each one of these back to all. So we have a script here that does that for us. Just reset values and you get all of the different data. And as you can see here, we're looking at the we're able to look at these charts that change automatically. So if I want to just look at exercise angina, notice all of our charts redraw, and we see how many records we find. We can go back to all, old peak, or no, ST slope, let's go flat, 456, and notice then we only see on the ST slope chart, we only see the flat, and we can go back to all. So just an example of using some a complicated query to build out this data and then, put it all on one sheet so we can, go and troubleshoot if we need, but also hide this data because what we're really wanting to look at is the data that we see when we use our filters to change the data. So again, reset values, we go back to all, And there we go. We are looking at our 918 different examples and looking at where our charts fall out.